Accessibility does seem to be a lot better than it used to be.
Well, it used to be that shield.
The window off the top.
Yeah.
Yeah. And now it's like the problem of whispering.
Yeah.
Pizza.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you. here. First off, I'd like to say it's been a blast, basically, this past year. Not that I did much.
Sorry to be on stage with the laptop. It has to be on.
Yeah, I know. I'm not as interesting as the. Seeing as I'm surrounded by a lot of talented people in SysAdmin who've done most of the grunt work, if you like, and not to mention the fact that we all have real CSO as an end. Nevertheless, I feel as if I have, learned something from the experience. Anyway, enough about that. I'm here tonight to give you what I like to call the state of the ProcSoc computer system address. Where I comment on the state of our network. Overall, not too bad. At least one of the servers fall over for whatever reason every now and again. We usually have no trouble getting up and running again in a reasonable time frame.
How many days since the last crash?
Oh, several months ago, actually.
You still have a sign that says 4 days since the last crash.
I'll ignore the sign.
It's like you've been up to 4 days.
It's like 8 years ago.
Although, I must mention, there is one server that has unfortunately gone down, Aglio P, which was a Dell PowerEdge 750 machine that served as both a backup for our primary firewall, Hasten-OE, and our primary user server, Nicholson. So, but basically what happened is you turn the machine on, and 30 seconds later the thing completely turns off by itself. Put it down to malfunctioning command, is that what it was? So, basically, if anyone would like to somehow fund a replacement van or even a replacement server, that would be awesome. I mean, even though it's not really essential, not a real urgency because the other two servers are doing their job quite well. Nevertheless, it's nice to have a backup. We're still using the fan, as you saw earlier tonight, to keep the servers cool.
How effective actually is that?
Well, it hasn't fallen over too much, has it? So it must be doing its job.
So it's got a good
answer. It could have a I mean, unless you can suggest a more high-tech cooling system, that's so.
It's better than window open, it's not going to get dust.
Mm. Although we do have a window open at the time.
Yeah,
before
that,
not doing
that.
But we don't have any air conditioning in there.
Can't the fan extract from that pipe? That doesn't give us any. If you extract air out of that ceiling fan, that will be fine. Except not to extract into the fan.
No. Yeah. Operating system upgrades. We've done several on our servers. Nibelheim and Muscle. Upgrading from Ubuntu 7.10 to 8.04, if I'm not mistaken. Guess it'll be up to the next CSO decide when to do another upgrade. Our Mac Minis, two of them run Ubuntu. One runs 8.04, another one is 9.04. 9.10, found out. 9.10, did they? One of them jailbirds the 8.04 machine. Jailbirds Mac OS 10.4 and Ubuntu. So we have just the one Mac OS machine, purely Mac OS 10. And for some reason, it has NFS disabled, but I don't know why.
I think it all. Yeah, basically, it was disabled like a year and a half ago. And NFS kept falling over. When it falls over, Mac becomes, every machine in the entire network becomes unusable. So it was this is our backup machine, so for when shit goes wrong, we can actually have a machine that has internet access that can be used.
Things like NFS change a lot.
for I didn't think you expected to be still being like that.
is it possible to, I don't know, run VMware or something in those to get both two of those? It's probably
yeah.
Not VMware.
Yeah, I've got a gigabyte of RAM each that would make me pretty
process and the organization.
Yeah.
Well,
I don't think it's easier.
Yeah. No, that's fine, we're discussing.
What's the pizza
service? Pizza service cooking. So, delivering very shortly. One aspect of the system that we would like to improve on, however, is our NFS. At the moment, we have a grip, that's our file and web server. It has a fat disk on it, which is our RAID 1 pair of hard disks. Contains all the user's name directories, as you know. As it turns out, this is the part of the system that tends to, you know, fall over the most, in my experience anyway. Crypt isn't exactly the newest machine, I think. Christopher, you donated by 2002.
Not that one.
It's 2002. Yeah, basically. Basically, it's doing file and LDAP duties as well. So, to that end, it has been suggested that we somehow purchase a NAS unit, a dedicated NAS unit. They do cost a fair bit, and we're not making native money, it's a treasure earlier tonight. So, if it could help us out in some way, that'd be much appreciated.
Do you have access to
the as quick as possible, because for me it wasn't really that quick. It took months. It was a drawn out experience for me trying to beg people for certain passwords. That was I was constitutionally tight. But you know.
Most handovers are gone.
Yeah.
Use the root password.
That's good. it's not that simple.
When you want to, there is no root password.
But yeah, no, I've collated a lot of the information, so
you've collated what?
So which machine?
the server, which got turned into something we are seeing to occasionally, except that Chrome Drop broke and has moved on since. I mean, they said it's been a year since I've been.
It's really
still
hard.
Broken.
You said you're looking for a new
And you back up to a replacement of cyber security.
Well, we want to avoid getting another straight voice sounds that every time we do that, it's CC break, and we're not quite sure what we're doing.
So you want
wrong?
Probably,
yeah.
I want something that has hardware range and
nice
range
for
us to grab.
Currently, we do not have any hardware range.
And no backups.
I was under the impression our current file server was by the break one.
I'm only going by what it says on the fleet machines, but
it was running read one at one point, but the read broke.
Yeah.
So it's not read anymore.
No.
It's just synchronized.
It's right, it's just synchronized.
Yeah.
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 We haven't had the pizza yet. What does the pizza say?
It's leaving now.
What,
really? It's leaving now, but it'll be here very shortly.
It's been leaving the store for about 5 minutes now.
Yes. It takes a bloody long time to get out of the door. Okay.
There's a chap that has
to
do it. He has to stop and have a pizza reserved first.
Exploring.
Fortify yourself.
It's
got a bagel
up there.
Sorry, carrying on.
I wish my successor, be it James or Noah, the best of luck. You're going to need it.
Okay, next we come to the elections. Are there any further nominations for any positions?
We don't accept your resignation.
Constitution said, you know, all the useful bits, rip.
You
know, fuck it.
You
want
to
know what you want.
There's still
some
constitution.
No, they need to remove it.
Okay.
Probably
should actually be right.
Just accept.
Yeah.
I'm here too.
Is it
a joke?
That's
not
a problem.
No,
you're not surprised.
What about actually
some risk?
Sorry, I'll finish my.
I'm going to take over as returning officer now and go through this. I'll introduce the candidates one at a time with any amended ones. And we'll let them have their speeches and then tell them to get the hell out or we vote on them on the way. So, for president, as mentioned, Margaret Colville and Justin Stewart, I'd now like to invite Margaret to give a speech on why we should vote for her.
Had to disable the recording, like, no.
Sleep mode. Okay, as I introduced myself at the start of this, I am Margaret Caldwell. I have been exec since my first year. Don't worry, I'll get to the catchphrase. I'll get there. I haven't been treasurer, but I've been secretary and vice, and I know how the club runs. I do a lot of things behind the scenes for the club. I do a lot of things behind the scenes. I run, get drinks. Yes, CK, did you want something?
I'm going to save it for behind the scenes.
Right, okay, well, yep. I go and get drinks, I chase up various people, like Jennifer from the union, when we need things from the union. With me in charge, it would be a golden year.
Because I know what we're all here for, pizza. obviously, my name's Justin. I've been a student here for about as long as Margaret has. I haven't been on the exec for as long as Margaret, although I was CSO.
Yes, you were elected the same time I was.
Yes, but I haven't been on exec for us. I wasn't last year. I suppose at this point I should make all the grand promises about all the wonderful things I'll do with Progzog. But realistically, the more promises people make, the more disappointed you get when you realize they're not going to fulfill them. So instead I'll say, I'll do what I can, when I can for the club. And, yeah.
Get back in here.
But any votes for anyone else?
No.
I
think they
you can stay there, but so we need you in here now.
Basically, I'll be steadfastly loyal to Margaret here. I will assist her to the best of my ability. I'll even take the
job.
Yeah.
Okay, I will come bearing money.
So, let us reconvene the meeting.
Okay, just for anybody who has really short-term memory loss, my name is Justin.
I have no.
What's your name? Ignore that one. What's your name?
I can't fucking remember it.
Like I said before, I'm not going to make any promises. What needs to be done, I will do. Not any of those. I will not take a bullet. I like living.
Yeah. Oh. Kelsen might be a bit upset too.
Yes, plus yeah. There's always somebody else who's depending on me, living under a roof. No, that's already promised to somebody else. But I will do what's needed to keep the club afloat.
Yeah.
I never promised that.
Go.
So, Justin and Tom would like to step up.
No, that's his name.
Oh, you're
which one?
This game's me.
Two nominations? No, I think we had two nominations. So we have had three nominations for the role of vice president for those of you who are as old and amnesia as I am. So can I have a show of hands for Tom Bosick?
So what happens when you break out?
Yeah.
personally.
We want to remove Tina from the pool and have another count.
She's not preferential.
No,
there's a drama photo.
And have a vote, a show of hands for Tom, please.
Which is clearly why I should handle your monies. Well, I know how to add and subtract, and I'm working on division, but I hear you don't need to use that much in finances. Sorry. I'm an IT student, not a business student. Oh, something like that. I think I would be competent for treasurer. Yes?
If you become treasurer, what do you estimate the balance will be in 12 months' time?
Estimate?
Well, can we be above $1,000 by the end of next year?
I don't see why not. However, I think that if we... well, it's not really the... Well, I guess it is the treasurer who says you can't have money.
And the treasurer is trying to handle how much money is coming in and out.
Yeah,
and
true.
And the treasurer who prepares forward estimates, cash flow statements, you know, that sort of thing.
Cash flows.
Maybe I should. Sorry?
I'd like to nominate
for... Where am I going to invest our money?
Second. Yeah.
Sorry, what's going on now?
Since 1998. That's several years. And as I look around, I remember other people who were present in 2003 who will remember the golden year. The golden year. That's right. For something else. For the golden year that I delivered as president to this august society.
Yeah. We're running for treasurer.
That's right.
Can you get us to $10,000?
If I delivered a golden year in 2003 as president, can you imagine how much gold I will deliver in 2010 when I have my hands on the money?
Estimate of how much gold this is.
For this and other reasons, I regret that I must decline the nominee.
I stand by some guy.
You take a bullet for
president. CSO, I'd probably be obliged to. So I'm perpetually an undergrad here. I actually work full time as a software developer. My background's pretty varied. I know computer hardware, I know software, I know building websites. I like building websites. And I'm gainfully employed, so if computer needs a fan, it's like $20, no big deal. And I think
free stuff.
I think
$20 is free now. It's like, I don't want to use a treasure.
I also like, you know, I choose these words carefully to maybe clean up a few things. And like,
can you tell us what you mean by clean up?
Can you imagine like a 12-port PowerPoint screen to the desk at the back? Like that's what I'm thinking. No. So,
what's the word hygiene mean to you?
Hygiene. Yeah, like what context?
Obviously not shaving.
Yeah, that's, I mean, I'm fiscally responsible, don't want to spend too much on razor blades. I should run for it. No, I should.
Wait, you can't afford razor blades?
It's because I spent all my money on fans.
How cool do you need to be?
I've mingled with rays, I've mingled with mass. So I've got, you know, broad scope, blah, blah, blah. And I think I'm a pretty cool guy, TM. So, yeah, that's, I'm just going to end on that.
I would now like to invite Noah Donahue to come on, because it's that way he is more of a man than James Duggan.
I'm sorry for having the first serious speech today. Last year when I was nominated for CSO, I basically said I don't have enough time because I was working full time as a Windows sysadmin. This year I'm not working at all, I'm a full time uni student, I've got plenty of time to fix up Proxox network, and I even have data recovery skills, just in case. If I am voted as CSO, there's quite a few things I'd like to fix and look at. Operating all the operating systems to a decent level would be a start. Seeing what we can do about the NAS. And
that's what impressed me.
Yeah.
Look at his speech on an electronic device.
I'd like to actually plug in the UPS this year, and probably plug the fan into the UPS as well.
That's where I was calling.
If we're lucky, we might even have enough spare capacity for the fridge, but it might be pushing it. And yeah, I would really like to be the Proxox CSO so I can actually get some Unix system administration skills in, on my belt after doing Windows sysadmin and networking equipment. Yeah, that's about it.
CSO opportunity.
You did also have Tina accept the nomination. Would you like to say anything to
you? Yeah, it's got more technical skills.
Just we give them each a laptop in 5 minutes.
Do you want the Proxox? Probably have more sysadmin skills and he has more programming skills.
One builds websites, the other builds the Windows.
Because otherwise, we make you both join PFY and whoever gets root first.
You can both go outside and fight it out with Tina arbitrating. And if the survivor who we voted for comes back in, they'll be the CSO.
It's the other place, so. Small room, pump, that's if you want CSO.
Show of hands for
this is the only position that actually
far too
easy. It's
just all my infrastructure.
That's kind of important.
That's
awesome.
The cost of our club, the team and virtualization. Yeah, no one claims to be a better sysadmin. Do we believe it?
Well, he's back. He's pretty much lost.
He does have the traditional CSO thing against the list and stuff I like to do.
One that doesn't have quite as much experience.
Who's got the experience?
I was explaining to Priscilla what the PFY was.
Right.
No, because no one's saying no.
Yeah,
he said he wanted to learn, get the experience. That's PF1.
Yeah, but he was working.
He's actually
got
a PF1 for the last year.
Ah, so would he resent being
PF1?
He was your PF1, was he not?
Yeah.
I think basically people might.
So the other guy's better than PFY. He's freshman.
He's freshman.
That's the other guy who didn't know exec at all.
No.
He doesn't get access. He's
like being like. Okay. So Noah's served a year as PFY, and he claims to have better sysadmin skills.
But he's looking to get experience.
Well, see, that was the other guy.
So that's
good.
Sysadmin skills put more on the Windows side.
What's the Unix experience? He did a year as PFY and he found him satisfactory. He's getting
employed apparently, which is
all I know about. And now he has all the time in the world.
Yeah.
I'm tempted to move him up to CSO and get myself the allocation of his PFY.
Probably Reese. Let's get this.
That was a serious. Can I see a show of hands for Tina? Excellent.
Are you still alive out there?
We can't, the guy whistles it up there.
Oh fuck, they might still stand it. I love how all this is on camera too.
Congratulations,
Noah.
Your president.
Were you faithful to Congress?
Yeah.
Will you take bullets from first years?
Oh, I don't know. I'll make it a second year at least.
We take bullets from first years.
Yes, because there is no one else running against me. I said I'd stand down if anyone ran against me. There's a lot in that room.
You look pretty
efficient. I do absolutely nothing, except occasionally I talk to alumni. Actually, I do a lot of the secretarial work and the systems admin work and president's work, because they run out to do crap all. But I actually want to talk about what I really can do for the club this year, which is far more important. You see, the union has this new program where you have to be an advantage card member. You have to have three of them on your executive, otherwise they complain and bitch and moan. So not only can I do this having an advantage card of my own right here for this year, I have a picture of an octopus on here. I'm an octopus. I put it to you that we need more tentacular rights in this. So now that the job of the returning officer is done, I'll hand back over to the chair.
Yes. Okay, now
we'll
be back to me. Okay, next item is, as Thomas was just mentioning, the union now has a 1-year
advantage members. I am Thomas's. Do we have him? Excellent. Moving on.
Otherwise, one would have to find an examination.
Yeah.
I have to find another executive.
Okay, next item. Any, so we have general business. First item is Tom's prepared speech on the TMM.
Oh, yeah.
Did you say the TMM?
Yes.
Nice.
It's manually done something as well.
It's like a dangerous one, too.
Yes,
yes,
it's a blue ring octopus.
Does your one say that it expires on the 31st of March or something?
They all say the first
year.
Yeah, they're all wrong.
It's just the student template is wrong and they can't update it. So every student card is wrong.
Probably they'd fix it, but this is why they never got back to me. It all makes sense now.
Okay, well, yeah, basically, I'm talking about it because I'm more or less the editor, so to speak, of this TFM. Yeah, just sort of assume the role. Basically, we started working on a brand new TFM. TFM 2010, we're going to publish it this year. Go on the way, we started November 2009, set up a little repository, SVN repository, with editing LaTeX files, as we did before. Quite a fair bit of work. We're up to revision 70, but we're still not finished. A couple of chapters need to be finalised, and then we can go to print. Just a brief overview of stuff that's changed. Changed the order of the chapters a little, created three new sections. You've got your basics, you've got your tools and applications, which cover all this. Tools and applications. And there's a programming section, which is, the sections are self-explanatory. Before you had chapters like TARDIS stuff and networking, which is kind of meaningless, really.
It was funny.
It's funny. Chapters were all over the place as well. Consolidated a few chapters as well, the rules and regulations chapter and what is the thing with ProcSol chapter, consolidated all that into one chapter, basically several other chapters. We've got a nice single introductory chapter to Unix now, just one chapter. There's a greater emphasis now on programming and computer science, so thanks in part to Thomas's exciting chapter on computer science he's working on. It's quite interesting read, and quite interesting proposition as to how World War II began. Worth a read.
It started with the some computer taking over the world.
And I've also put back, there was a chapter on Haskell, if I put that back in. Haskell. It was meant to be for the last edition, but didn't make it. Chris is Chris Dagan, he updated Kirk and various other little tidbits around there, so thank you very much for that. James is let's not forget James. James has been doing sterling work on the new HTML chapter.
That's so much more.
It's
HTML, CSS, JavaScript,
and also
all
other insects. I had to ask Lee Fix, who's not here tonight, a little whimsical picture of a frog sock, which will appear in the first chapter. Yeah. You can have a look at that. Right, basically, this is a sample of the sample couple of chapters here off the two games I was showing at O'Day. Yeah. Some other people actually plan to write some chapters. I might mention that I know Rob said you're going to do PHP.
I'm
going
to do a PHP framework. I'm seriously thinking that PHP frameworks pointed to a chapter on Python Django. But, you know.
I mean, it's still open. It's still free.
Hey, Rob, would you like to write a chapter on the ocean?
And how about a framework?
Can we add a chapter of recursion just as C recursion?
Yeah.
Can we do that?
Oh, yes.
Oh. It should have
been done years ago. Yeah, Trees mentioned that he was going to do a chapter before. And Thomas's associate, O'Day, wanted to write a chapter on Conway. That's pretty much sort of work in progress. Yeah, well, Bondi and Tesla, where is it? Yeah, we actually wanted to break this in time for O'Day. It didn't happen. I don't know. But yeah, we're... yeah.
Oh.
2010 is the working.
I split the world out of them, so...
I guess so.
TFN is wanting to force me to the apocalypse, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, it's obviously
Prog Soft. Yeah, but yeah, we're aiming for mid-year now. I am hell-bent on getting this thing printed this year, so we can say it's TFN 2010.
I think just in time for 2011.
just
with regards
to Christmas.
Just with regards to O'Day, we need a second store, and just at that store we say we would prog rock society.
What?
And so we get twice as many memberships.
How many people here like progressive rock? Really?
No, it's not about the rock at all. It's about getting people into the club and then just
talking
about
it.
The
concept
of
it
rocks you. Hashtag
rock
song would be so much better.
It's rock song. Yeah, why not?
Yeah, it's pretty much like barbecues as well.
I'm not topic, but I just trying to say.
Yeah, and also, Prue mentioned earlier that we're seeking a production grant for this from the union to at least partially cover the costs. So. Yeah, Margaret can sign that now she's president, so that's all good.
We can start decided how much we're going to sell it for.
Yeah, that's one of the questions. I had $5 for 18 members, 10 for 18 members, but anyone can suggest a better price. So.
Just by the by, every other year we did this, we got the faculty to pay things for a
gift. Right.
Yeah, but
that's
really
it's
GST.
I gather things have changed around here since the golden
year.
But,
yeah.
We also used to get $10 out of everyone.
Right.
It is worth $10. Yeah. Giving you size is true. We can make it $5 when it's few years in the other day.
Yeah.
Right? So
we might give them away last year.
I think for somebody who's got nothing to do with the clerk or walked in off the street in 20 years, $20. So that kind of exception. But what standard price should we tell them?
In any case, I did do a bit of research as to, you know, shopping around to the various printing establishments, you know, I found the UTS printing services is in fact the cheapest.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, set $700 ex-GST for at least 100 copies.
Yep.
So, yeah. Some of the places they're charging like 1,200, which is ridiculous.
No one's unbearable.
Yeah. And as you see, there's a cover design. That's Rob's cover design here.
Needs to be cleaned up.
Yeah. Are we going through
like
a projector?
Anyone have a laptop?
One
afternoon.
No, I think
that's
no one takes it.
There's
only
laptop
384.
Like,
They finally canned my account.
Yeah,
So you can see on the topic of TFM cover art, you can see a whole bunch of things on display. Won't be showing it tonight. You can have a look in your own time, I guess.
Good question. So you said the target for getting this out is mid-year. What do you plan as far as specific dates or milestones? At what point do we say, okay, this chapter's not going to be written, let's ditch those chapters and go through it regardless? Do you want to try and set up something like that so that it's not a perpetual rolling?
I'm against the idea of just printing it when it's not clearly ready. It needs to be ready. We're aiming for O-Day before. Clearly it wasn't ready, but it was an artificial deadline.
Does it need to have one in order to get things rolling, or is it a case of...
It's good to have a deadline to focus on, to motivate yourself, really, basically. But no, there's no fixed deadline as such.
So which is it? Are you going to fix a deadline to motivate us, or are you going to define what a ready TFM looks like and wait until you hit that?
Do you want a fixed deadline?
I'm asking you, because so far you've done neither.
I would say we fix a deadline for the new chapters.
Right.
Any new chapters which aren't at least started by the end of the month get cut.
Yeah.
This month?
End
of April.
This month is still the order.
I know.
You have 5 days to start the chapters.
Yeah, more else.
Do a synopsis.
Yeah, so maybe we should adopt the hard deadline approach. That's probably the best way to get this out of the door.
Sorry, I'm writing the conversion chapter.
Have you finished?
It's all late, George.
Right.
The main condition will be different.
That's basically it. I think we can move on to the rest of the
agenda. Okay. Next item on the agenda, PFY. Any suggestions on who we should...
the CSO's choice. Why are we nominating?
Step one, alcohol wipes, so they don't work, and new keyboards.
Sometimes you just throw a thing out.
You can't really eat everything. Have you seen the boxes?
Well, part of that is the fact that last time when I tried to throw stuff out, I wasn't, because Rob said it was all too awesome to be thrown.
Wait, no, we sorted into an awesome and a not awesome box. The not awesome box is still there. There's still a big coward server.
What was the way we fucking fixed this? Miles was involved somewhere.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that was the year that Adam's Scala was the room bitch.
And
then
went missing.
And then
killed
Balsamog.
Okay, during the molting process, that was also the point at which a fork got stuck into Sutek while it was on. The Hillman. This organizes molting all the better.
Yeah, it was
a retirement. Yeah, it's
just
time, except we had data on that we needed, and it was fucked.
So your suggestion is a spoon?
I just turn it off before you stick the fork in.
The way this basically works is you get one chance a year to really throw stuff out in that room. That chance is this evening. The new exec should wander through and pick out things that they don't want in the room and remove them.
We should just throw it out.
The way we do it in previous years is we build a big stack of it out the front of what used to be called the interface room. I don't know what it is now.
It's called the window.
No, it's in
general.
Anyone who wants any of this stuff is free to grab it before the faculty throws it out.
Yeah.
And then 3 weeks from there, we get a note from the faculty saying, could you please throw your own shit out?
At which point it goes back in the room?
We take it down to the skips on level 0. They're like, we're not sure which is the sculpture and which is the secret metal that you guys have thrown out. Can you please determine this for us?
The sculpture now has a little sign against it saying, please do not touch the artwork.
Please do not put it in the toilet and let it dry.
Please do not put this into a toilet and put it on another level. Because after 4 years of 4 weeks of searching,
They found it within a week.
But they do have a CCTV.
We don't know.
It's just some kind of ISIL that they dumped in front of our room, and so we dragged it into a toilet cubicle on level 5, unlocked the door, and it's stuck out.
It's 6 people.
It weighs a lot. I used to lock my bike to it.
they found it and brought it back.
Yeah, they found it.
But it goes into a toilet with no toilet in it. I mean,
the fact that there are like 6 giggling students wandering around trying to be heavy on it might have tipped them off.
No one watches those cameras.
They can pull up records if they notice like a statue missing or something.
A lot of us got caught. Nothing ever happened except it showed up there.
And said you came back the very next day.
Okay, moving on.
What?
Next item, new plot. This first year, do you want to tell us your grand plans for how you're going to find hundreds of new members for us?
Okay, I've got a couple of lectures on. I can go to the front of the room and advertise. The ones that go in and they scream at the front. Yeah.
So what do we bring to first years? Besides, we're a bunch of that's not a word.
We know the answers to assignments.
Yeah, you can
help
me. Yes,
I
can help you with my assignments.
We mark the assignments. We give the students the marks we want. I mean, barely mark them all.
Does anybody else have any ideas for how we should bring some new blood in?
The main thing is to sign them up. They don't care if they don't turn up after that.
Yeah.
Well, yes and no. I mean, we still need sort of people around for the next year.
We don't want a ComSoc situation.
People who actually sort of tell me how well attended the Thursdays are.
Average would be 6 to 8. With occasional outlines. Between 4 and 12.
Because the thing is, those are not advertised at all whatsoever. I forget from year to year that there are actually Thursday meetings on.
We need to
put
up another poster again.
We should say,
do you have
the picture? If they were advertised, I would turn it off because I would remember that they were on.
Well,
So this leads me to my point, which is that
you have one job to send a mail to him every 5 minutes.
Why don't you send it to PropSoc announce?
Unions, what's on
there?
We've done that occasionally. It's not really worth it. Like, you have to be in sort of 6 weeks in advance or something, and then we never remember.
You keep in mind that's a free thing that recurring costs you. 6 weeks in advance, say, come to Thursday night.
What we used to do was, I don't know if they've changed it, but we used to just say, please put us on all for the entire year, or at least the entire semester.
Except that you seem to fall off it very quickly, which sucks.
Well, good.
Who is the secretary?
Who's going to stay on top of that? That's the secretary business.
Right.
Staying on top of our thing in the union.
We expect at least 91%.
That's how I found out that PropSoc was on every Thursday, just reading up.
Another thing might be worthwhile is putting up a big poster outside, is changing it to be the kind of props on the Thursday.
We might do well to have something over the front page of the wiki as well, which I'm not sure we do have.
It's not on the front page, at least it's on the
front page. Yeah, but it's a pretty important page as it is.
It's like one of those meetings.
Every other club I've been spams pretty much everything they do by email at the beginning of every week.
You didn't post it to the start writing.
You can do that too.
Mr. Start account.
Well, I'm from Sydney, that does things differently, but every club I've been mails me every Sunday to say what they're doing that week. The question was whether we should have a Facebook group.
Can we already have one?
And whether it's a good idea to have it maintained. And Christian asked me whether it was a good thing or a tardboy thing. Now, because we're the computing society, we are kind of a little bit beyond Facebook. We have better tools. But that said, many other clubs use their Facebook groups very successfully for organizing the events, because people click on them, they get added to calendars, they get reminded about it. So it's working for lots of other clubs. We should do it.
Well, we do have Facebook. It's just not particularly touched.
Okay.
This
the current owner, but it's the exact need to get the webpage owner.
That's a good point. There's a few people on it.
I think I have some.
Yeah, I think you've got this. Yeah. Well, confirm. We can get
and then, yeah, and then send the thing to PropSoc and notes.
Yeah.
We could even do some little programming thing. Sorry for suggesting actually a program to just take the mailing list and dump it onto the Facebook page.
Actually, that's the
possibility. Every time you send a new message, it goes on the Facebook page, it goes to PropSoc Announce, and your mailing
list. Also, use the mailing list to mass invite people to our Facebook page.
Yeah, that's what I thought you might have been saying.
Yeah, that's where I thought you were.
Yeah, just dump out the entire subscriber list in Facebook.
Yeah, you don't need programming to do this. I'm suggesting something that requires
That is an interesting idea if someone wanted to pick up the Facebook API and look for actually, there's still money in loading the Facebook API and making dodgy apps. So it could be good for somebody to pick that up.
On your identities. What comes next after
farming?
Does it really get much lower than farming?
You have to cultivate it.
It's server farms. Can you imagine how rich we could get? If the moment Mark's Farmville doesn't
it
take
sense.
It down, I think that is the mafia.
Well, could you host Farmville in Serverville?
I like that.
Do you run virtual Farmville as a virtual server?
Do we still have an external facing IP addresses and such?
Yes.
Everything.
Let's see how much money we can make off some kind of Facebook scam.
I think you mean app, not scam.
That's about it.
More people using your app. Quick, set up more Cassandra servers.
Paste this horrible JavaScript into your address bar to invite everyone, because Facebook is disabled now.
Okay, next item. Future. Is there anything people want us to do in the future? Any events you guys want us to hold?
barbecue.
How about Robo Joe?
Specifically, someone actually met a jetpack that works recently.
Have you been staring at my chest?
How much jetpacks are you around in
6 months? I'm asking for it.
So, how about
sorry,
a serious suggestion? Like one
well, that wasn't serious.
No, I thought it was actually
out
of serious.
I
yeah.
the way.
Okay,
so
it's
throw it up.
The last 3 or 4 years and then never took off. So,
Chris, what
yeah.
are you saying?
Oh, I was suggesting you listen to Rob because he suggested something and then, as a joke, suggested, hey, how about RoboCode? Because that always took off. But,
fair enough. No,
I'll
we suggest that every year, including the golden year.
Yeah,
or
I was there.
Any other suggestions?
What's that? UTS. Speech thing, what's that called?
UTS Speaks.
UTS Speaks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
UTS Speaks.
It's a. I'm not really familiar with it, but I think it's sort of a series of talks given by notaries.
Is it IT related?
It can be.
It can be, but it's not specifically. It's, I think there's been some science problems and things like that. If we organise something, we might.
Tie in
with it, but I think they mostly
organize
it themselves.
So, do we want to have another one of the network days? Mm-hmm.
Actually,
up the room days.
Yeah, we do need one of those.
We checked out the LDAP server.
Who is ProSoft after backing up all the data from the LDAP server?
That would be fun then.
You stick the fork in the
back. Who
do we have in ProSoft who understands Python web frameworks and wants to talk about?
Ooh, give me a few weeks.
Because I would attend that.
I developed in general, but I don't always say I don't know enough to give a presentation.
Okay,
you it?
Trying to get student leads for your startup or?
No, no, it's. I feel as an old pastor that Web 2.0 is nearly being applied. I understand Git and Pokes, I don't understand Ajax and other horrible things.
But you never did sockets program?
I did sockets.
I can sort of link the Web 2.0 without any specific language content. Except maybe Java.
So basically you can babble on about buzzwords?
Mm. Nah, I mean more buzzwords. Mostly like XHR. Sorry, that's
not it. Fail.
Actually, I went to one of the developers at work and I said, hey, the problem is XHR. He goes, what? I'm like, you know, XML HTTP. What? I'm like,
Ajax
call. He's like, oh, why didn't you say so? I'm like, it's not XML. It's JSON.
So, James is giving a talk then.
I was going to suggest, hey, how about some, you know, some lightning talks or something, but every time that's been suggested, it's gone wrong. But hey, I'd be generally interested if we could set a date well in advance and say, we will hit this date and have X amount of talks or something. Or just set something to aim for rather than, hey, next week, let's have some lightning talk things.
Does anybody else feel like they'd be capable of doing
that? When the alumni rep in the first year rep got added as an exec position, the constitution wasn't changed. They're not exec positions. That's why they're not in that document.
It wasn't changed.
There's no records on it. If you pulled up on the rank, but there hasn't been anything that's come up. We've looked for it.
The wiki has a record.
The wiki has a record of it being added?
Yep.
What date?
The wiki has pretty much all of the components we've been able to find.
Mm.
Including the AGM from 1995,
okay.
Which I dug up from a box somewhere from the bottom of the universe.
Let's go with something that's actually been changed.
It's
changed.
AGM goes 94.
Mm. Yeah.
That was
95.
I
dug up
94.
If there's something in there, like one of the AGM minutes actually had that as a line item, which is
description.
Then
a description of all the amendments ever made to the Constitution, and all the copies of all the Constitutions were.
Okay. Is there anything else people would like to talk about?
Just in the first year, so are there any actual roles associated with it?
That's what we were just saying.
Yeah, I know, but like, there are none, so is it just like to represent the first year?
That's why we need
this
online, just to clarify.
just to make sure that's what they do.
My understanding from my time on the exec is that the role of the first year exec is, first year representative, is both to represent first years within the executive and to make sure that they get fair treatment from us older people who've been around far too long and think it's our appointment for. Particularly people like Marauder who never go away. On the other hand,
why was I giving this example? I'm a new chum on the life membership board.
No, I think I got my life membership on new more recently than you did. So the other role is to advertise ProgSoc to first years and try and encourage them to join us.
What I meant is that at least have a line there instead of
letting
people assume.
Anyone can
have
the
movie,
right?
We can add to the constitution, but we can't do it tonight because it needs to be done through the formal procedures. So we can discuss it tonight. Someone would like to do it, put it to the exec, we can put it to the list, or an SGM to do so. Basically, we can't do it tonight. Let's not waste time talking about it. That's my view.
Just make a nice new page on the wiki.
The whole thing, what I read is to prevent the people that in the club from using the online
accounts.
Oh, yeah, sort of. If you see, it's to prevent the others abusing the alumni because that's my privilege.
Mm-hmm.
At the same time, I have to make sure the executive can't do anything else to the alumni.
Probably the alumni rep has shifted suddenly over the years. Since
yeah,
it was,
from me to you.
Since it was created as a way to give Christian the key to the room, even though he was thoroughly unsuitable for any other executive position. So we made a new exec position for the one guy rep and gave him the key. That's why it has no roles. Its only role was to give Christian a key.
Well, things have worked. He still has a key.
It's not its job, but now we can't.
Oh, I'm building on
right,
it, so I'm pretty intentionally to ProgSoc. I mean, obviously, it's here for someone who's been around long enough and who isn't alumni to do something interesting for ProgSoc.
Yeah.
Whether it's just keep a key or add tentacles.
Anything else from the floor?
Yeah.
One question. What was the final resolution about the wiki links?
The camera's running now, so.
Yeah.
Sorry, Chris, your racism?
Have we got any thoughts about possibly improving the user registration process since we've got these people now?
Where is it now? Talking about the user registration at the moment.
It's currently on a partially broken version of Rocket that Rob hacked.
It was working for a while, and Ant said, I don't like this, and then sort of click delete, basically, from what I remember.
It worked, and then Ant deleted part of the old registration, it now doesn't work with the system. So you can add them through it, but it doesn't have their password.
We had the registration Python script and the thing, and that's how I just sort of... It's whiz. Now we've got people learning Python, we may as well reinstate it on YouTube. As an old suggestion, maybe start with just using that as a base. Again, if we need to modify it,
should we can apply for that?
Yeah, no, they're still looking around. It should be on Crack.
We also have people that sign up using the website every so often and we never hear from again because it says, an exec will contact you shortly.
Does it have our bank details for them to put money in?
Yes,
is that so like...
Why does the money ever show up?
Did we
have
a game at one
point?
No.
One year we had a credit card machine and we spent a lot of money on
that.
For
many years,
it's
spent a lot of money on
that. Why is it a paper?
I don't know which is more dangerous.
Can I join?
Just a question.
Yes.
Is there any out of the box solutions we could possibly use for that sort of thing?
I'm a web developer and I'm not in the box.
That's because we get into the box and then get an out of the box solution by removing it from the box.
I like your suggestion.
Wouldn't it be swell if the union provided something to all clubs to manage their user base?
Yeah.
We should take that slam.
Yeah.
Why don't we develop one then?
Sell
it
out
to
me. That's a
great idea in theory, and I considered it momentarily, and then I also considered ProgSoc's track record for
project in the United
States.
Which is I've never seen a single thing finished in this society in all my years.
Oh, but wait, we started some things.
I don't know if I can get on here.
We
we've finished many things.
But
just define things like a cleanup day or set up this new server.
But as someone said, this out of the box thing, if you can find something that's out of the box, even if it involves money, then tell the union to buy it for a minute. Tell the union.
With regards to like PayPal, the iteration graph is like, but the more time you spend, the less it looks like PayPal.
See, I think the main thing we want to try and resolve is the fact that we're currently managing the entire clubs. As to whether or not.
It was.
Yeah,
that's
I mean, that one was enjoying.
Is it probably the legendary spreadsheet?
No.
Do you actually want like proper accounting software?
Well, something that can tell us, okay, this user hasn't paid, you know, this user's been active since this time and hasn't paid since this time.
This sounds like a fantastical application of a relational database.
It does, doesn't it?
Yeah, why don't we just do that?
You happen to be doing a PLS.
Well, the funny thing is, the currently partially broken, well, in the sense that it users go to the website and we get this email, is actually an SQL database somewhere.
In true IT style, when they sign up to the website, they go into one database. When they use Webmin, they go into another database. And the LDAP system has a separate database altogether. So there's three different databases, and the LDAP is a backend database, the local login database is on our system. This is why it's easy.
Can we make it
Yes.
Could
an infinite number of programmers in SysAdmin install this in a single third
database?
No,
it's like
that.
Building a BPS hosting company. So.
Maybe have a look at this at the end so you have the details.
Yeah.
Okay.
I
thought we
were
being
adjourned.
If anyone hasn't paid to see
the
office,
you have to pay.
Yeah.
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 Yeah.